Hello, and a very warm welcome to Alenti Royal YouTube channel.
Meghan Markle has no regrets quitting the royal family, and has been telling her pals she can have it all. A close friend exclusively told Alenti Royal channel.
Meghan has no regrets and the sky's the limit.
She said feel like a huge weight has been lifted, as the insider explained.
The Duke and Duchess of Sussex recently made a trip to Miami, where Prince Harry spoke at a J.P. Morgan's Billionaire Summits, during which Harry spoke about his mental health and therapy. Until the jaunt to Florida, the couple had been holed up with their 9-month-old son Archie at a waterfront Vancouver Island mansion.
They've been spending quality time together as a family.
Meghan has been cooking and making homemade baby food for Archie, the friend said. Now with a routine in place, Meghan has been taking the steps to relaunch her career, with the insider adding. Meghan said her work with Disney is far from over.
The voiceover is just the beginning, and that there's more collaborations to come. It was previously revealed Meghan signed a voiceover deal with Disney in return for a donation to the charity Elephants Without Borders.
The deal was made after Prince Harry was caught on film touting his wife's skills to Disney boss Bob Iger at the premiere of The Lion King in London in July 2019. It seems the couple, who said they wanted to be financially independent when they stepped back from their royal duties, are eager to forge ahead with their new plan.
Their visit to Miami marks the first public appearance Meghan and Harry have made as a couple since their shock announcement. One insider said the royals were smart to take the gig, adding, "It was a very smart move to get in with some of the world's richest people.
The conference is all about building wealth for future generations, and making the world better for future generations, a topic close to Harry's heart." Zron Tarashian, CEO of New York-based PR firm 5W Public Relations, told OMT Royal Channel, you would expect the couple to have made between $500,000 and $1 million from the appearance.
Doria Ragland fully backed her daughter's decision because she was really worried about Meghan, and is relieved that her daughter is putting her mental health and well-being first. Now, Meghan feels she can breathe again, the friend explained, adding the royals told her inner circle of friends that her soul was being crushed, and that the decision to leave was a matter of life or death, meaning the death of her spirit. So they continued. She also felt like she couldn't be the best mother to Archie, if she wasn't being her true, authentic self. Something she felt she couldn't be in the royal family confines. So she said she didn't want Archie picking up on her stress and anxiety. She felt like it was a toxic environment for him because there was too much tension and pent-up frustrations. Now relaxing in Canada, Meghan has been cooking and making homemade baby food for Archie, the friend said. They explained Meghan and Harry have been doing what regular families do since quitting their royal duties. They said, everything pretty much revolves around Archie right now and Meghan getting back into shape. They have a daily routine of doing yoga and taking long hikes. And it doesn't seem that Harry and Meghan will be returning to the UK anytime soon, as last month, it was reported that the couple are hoping to spend their summer in Los Angeles. Meghan has been telling her close friends that this is the best thing that could ever happen to Harry. That out of anyone he will flourish the most, and that it was her love for him that made this possible. Meghan told her friends that there is no rush to move out of the place they've been staying. That they're welcome to live there as long as they like. Meghan calls it her happy place and says that in the last couple of months, she's felt more at home than she ever did in the UK. In other news, the Queen's favorite grandson has confirmed he is divorcing his wife, saying, "It's sad, but is best for the kids." A statement issued on their behalf said, after informing the Queen and members of both families last year, Peter and Autumn jointly agreed to separate. They had reached the conclusion that this was the best course of action for their two children and ongoing friendship. The decision to divorce and share custody came about after many months of discussions and, although sad, is an amicable one.
the couple's first priority will remain the continued well-being and upbringing of their wonderful daughters Savannah and Ella. Both families were naturally sad at the announcement, but fully supportive of Peter and Autumn in the joint decision to co-parent their children. Both Peter and Autumn have remained in Gloucestershire to bring up their two children, where they have been settled for a number of years. The couple are in the process of divorcing, and Philip will be the first of the Queen's grandchildren to legally split. They wed at St. George's Chapel in Windsor Castle in 2008, and decided to split last year. Her Majesty is believed to be upset, after Autumn told Princess Anne's son she wants to end 12 years of marriage. It comes amid fears that the mum of two wants to follow Prince Harry and Meghan Markle to her native Canada. Close friends are suggesting that Mexit Prince Harry and Meghan's departure from the UK to Canada to could have hastened Autumn's shock decision. But the statement from the couple suggested both parents would remain in Gloucestershire to raise the children. It is believed the daughters have dual Canadian citizenship, which means they could easily live in Canada if Autumn were to return there. One pal revealed, "Peter is absolutely devastated by this and just didn't see it coming. He thought he was happily married and had the perfect family with two lovely daughters. But he is now in total shock. Autumn is a wonderful wife and mother and a very intelligent woman, but she's been telling her friends for some time that there were issues. She is a favorite of the Queen, and I'm sure Her Majesty will be very upset by this as well. It's the last thing she needs after all her recent troubles, and you get the feeling that the royal family is falling apart a little bit."
I don't think anybody had any knowledge it was coming. I noticed that various people are saying Peter Phillips splits from Autumn. I think it's the other way around, actually. It's Autumn splitting from Peter Phillips, and the Queen will be upset about it. She's always upset when something happens in the family. We've had a whole raft of things happen last year. Prince Philip's accident, Duke of York's car crash interview, Harry and Meghan going off into the sunset. You know, just one more thing.
And you mentioned Harry and Meghan. Of course, Autumn is Canadian. It's understood that the children have dual citizenship. Could this be another part of her family heading for Canada?
It could be. Her family is in Canada. She really doesn't have anybody here. Except her husband and her two children and friends, obviously. So it's a likelihood that she would go to Canada because that's where she's from, that's where her roots are still, I think, and that's where her family is.
Those close to the couple have expressed concern that Autumn might want to start a new life in Canada, just like the Duke and Duchess of Sussex have decided. A friend said, "What worries some of us is that Autumn may want to go back to Canada. Maybe she has been influenced by Harry and Meghan's departure. Perhaps she thought if that can happen then I can leave as well. That might be unfair on her, but you have to consider it. No other party is involved in the split," our sources said. A pal explained, "Certainly none of us think either Peter or Autumn are involved with anyone else. It just seems they have grown apart, but it's come as a bolt out of the blue for Peter and he's very upset. The split is the latest problem for the royal family after a disastrous year, which some commentators have branded a second Annus Horribilis." Another report. A royal author has claimed that Prince Harry is still deeply affected by Princess Diana's death, and by his unclear role as the second son. British writer Tina Brown, who penned the Diana Chronicles in 2007 and formerly edited Vanity Fair and Tatler, believes the lack of clear path for Harry, coupled with his mother's death and lack of career, has made him an unhappy man. However, she believes that the way Prince Charles has handled Prince Andrew's controversial exit from the royal family, along with Meghan and Harry's retreat from the limelight, proves he is ready to be king. Speaking to the New York Times, she said of Prince Harry, "I think the deep wounds of his mother's death have never healed. And his sense of his role as the second son, the fact that he loved his military career, but then left and didn't have that sense of purpose, all of that came together to make him a very unhappy man." She added, "I do think that Prince Charles's handling of these crises, and Mexit, has shown that he's ready to be king. He has rather risen to the occasion. He has been very decisive about Andrew, saying, he has to go, and about Harry he has managed to walk the line between being a father who cares about the mental health of his son and being someone who understands what the monarchy has to do to be self-preserving. Zazantina believes the royal family have a difficult task in keeping the public on their side in modern times.
Please support Growing LNT World Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos our. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos.
Don't stop.